Thank you.
Sidnee Michelle, Black Femme and TV.
You're.
Hi, Yootha. Hi, Kofi.
Hey, how are you?
I'm a hopeless romantic, so this film like did what it needed to do for me. So I just wanted to start. I love this film. One of the major things that stood out to me as a Howard alum was the authenticity of Black Love One and Black Love surrounded by the amazing city of DC. From having, you know, the DC band, Gold Link, the go-go music playing, and to see U Street and hear people talk about it, it was amazing. So I just wanted to say that you guys really like drove it home. My favorite thing, I think, though, was the scene where you two discussed being good enough. And I know, especially being Black in the creative fields, we get those looks from our parents. We get those questions. What are you doing? When is this going to pay off? Where's the money at? And I think you two have been so successful in overcoming that in your careers. So I just want to know, as a young Black creative, what can you tell those who are kind of in that funk of, what do I do next? How can I be good enough?
That's a beautiful question.
Thank you. Thank you. You want to go first?
Never underestimate how important independence is, you know? And I guess like the journey of developing like independence is like, that's gonna be an anchor at the end of it all. Even like through success, you know, it's like you have to be able to look in the mirror and know what you need next, to know what you don't need. And sometimes that comes with accolades, sometimes that comes with silence, you know? So just really like developing that journey of independence and just that relationship with self, that's something you should use, I guess, utilize the times where people aren't all up in your face and it's not all love and it's not all this and your parents might have a little doubt, your friend might not, but it's like you need, it's like immune, like, you know, you need a little bacteria for your immune system. It's like, you need a little bit of that to like know how it feels. So when it gets real, you could reference that and be like, oh, no, this is a part of the process, you know? So
that's something I would have told myself
a few years ago.
That's a really great answer. And I can add to that. It's almost like a neurological thing. You know, I watched this interview with this guy called Andrew Huberman. He's like a neuroscientist, and he just describes like the road to being successful. Mm-hmm. So there's this guy who's able to like, you know, run for miles and then do the craziest stuff that most human beings physically wouldn't be able to like endure. But people wonder, what is it? Is it some magic thing? And he's like, well, basically I know when my body wants to shut down, but I realize that that's just part of the process. Afterwards, you will get the rewards and your brain will let go of the dopamine. And that's when you feel satisfied. Absolutely. And if you're, you know, conscious of that process, that's when you start dealing with that. And culturally, that's going to be the same thing for Black people. It's always like a very intense road that kind of doubles up on everyone else. In a way, like as a female as well, but having that awareness from a very young age, just for the fact that you're Black, that just you can turn that into a superpower, because now you're conscious of that from in a very early stage. Now you use that in your favor, and you get like Black, you know, Black girl and Black boy magic.
Yeah,
but it was all there, you know. Everyone has it.
Yes, I would. Ooh, you did. That was such a good answer. My goodness, I want to end there. But just to close, I was like, ooh, I got goosebumps. To close, I think that this film was also so important because, like I said, we rarely see romantic Black films, romantic films with dark-skinned leads. And I think that it's so important. We usually see slave movies, you know, Black trauma, which is good for us to see and especially good for others to see. But this film was just so heartwarming. And I'm just like, nothing tragic can happen. Please. This is Nothing tragic, please happen. I want it to end. I want her to see this amazing artwork and they fall in love and they figure it out and then that's it. But my question to you guys is, how important do you think this film will be to those in our generation who don't see enough Black romance movies and to those to come, those generations to come?
I'll use myself as the first audience member. And I know from when I read the script, like the way it inspired me, And it kind of just like, it inspired me to believe in the process of love. And it's like, I could only hope that anybody else is inspired by the same things. Like, love is a process. There's a lot of work. Like, I mean, it's all work, you know? So there's so many processes you witness, but you also see the beauty of each stage and like the rewards of like actually like, you know, I guess enduring the process. So I think just that conversation is important. And obviously like, you know, the fashion is fly, the color, the music is on point, you know,
awesome, got on point.
People in the movie. Yeah. So I just think it's good representation of us, you know what I'm saying? In the simplest way. And it's like, we should see a lot more of it, but you know, it's a good start. It's a good start.
Yes, man. All right. Thank you guys so much for your time. You took Kofi, you did such a good, amazing.